What we're doing right now is we're setting the rings up, and you can do this in a false grip or not in a false grip. I'm gonna try to do it with a false grip when I do this workout. We're gonna start in a hang, establish a good false grip. We're gonna pull up to the top, be able to establish a good position, straighten that arm for a momentary hold, and pull it back in. That is one rep. Woo, that's gonna be fun. Obviously, you want to squeeze your elbows in nice and tight. You're going to want to really, really activate the lat on the shoulder, this stabilizing and holding the ring close to the body as you extend the other arm. The other thing is this line of sight is out and on the horizon, keeping your head neutral. And again, we're hitting that good position, right? Lat active, hips tucked under, abs are on, glutes are on. Just no break in the body. I'm going to go for that today. We can literally be here and we can hold on our toes and then begin to really cue that position. Notice what happens with the stability here. I'm starting to kind of move. You really got to cue those elbows in tight and keep those lats on. How else could we scale this thing? Well, I think you could definitely put your foot in a band, right? And we could take, it would decrease the load there. That would also help with stability. Wrap the foot, hang, hold, and extend. A couple things that you're gonna need to keep this workout a little safer if you can. If you don't have matting, I highly suggest picking a folding mat up on Craigslist and adding that to your arsenal in your gym. Bring your feet together, okay? Reach down, put your hands on the ground. Bend your knees a little bit, good. Now, lift your butt up to the sky as high as it'll go. Now, all I want you to do is look down at your knees and I want you to find the mat on your blades here, okay? So I want you to bypass your neck entirely. Ideally, if I were to spot this, we'd put him there. So he jumped a little bit, but we got him safe, okay? We got him past his head, which is super important. That is our rolling surface, which is those large muscles on the back that kind of parallel your spinal column. Get all the way out and up. You see how easy and safe that was in terms of just getting past your shoulders, getting past your head, and then standing up. I used to say this to little kids is, pretend like you're holding two pizzas. Again, we're gonna cue those elbows forward, which is gonna maintain that hollow. We're gonna look down, and we're gonna find the ground with our hands, but you're gonna continue to look at your belly button. That's gonna cue your hollow and your active shoulders, okay? And it's also gonna let your drive over fast. Biggest problem that happens here is you get disoriented. We lose connection and line of sight to what I like to call basically stare down at your crotch or your knees. And this is what happens immediately when you get upside down. And that's what we don't want to happen, okay? We don't want to open up. We want to continue to look, press, find the ground, and drive your toes quickly over. Start in a back squat position. We're gonna squat down to the bottom of our squat. All right, lats are on, and we're gonna press that bar just overhead. Keep your eyes on the horizon. Yeah, it's a little difficult, but right off your shoulders, knock one more out. There we go. And at the top, what are you doing? You're ripping the bar in half and dropping the shoulders, turning the lats on, right? Bink. There you go, take a break. Skilled workout in terms of what we do in CrossFit, but make sure you have a good, safe way to scale a few of these things. Make sure you go over them before you knock this one out. Cool.